Hello, everyone. It's August 6th, 2018, and this is day two of the Rock Bottom Vlogs, and my chair is very squeaky. Alright, so what was today like? Shit. It was kind of tough, actually. Suddenly got back problems this morning. I don't know what that's about, but I woke up and my body was just like, nope, we don't want to move or do anything right now. We're fucked. So, oh shit, can I say that? I'm going to get, whatever. It's too late now. So that sucked, but I ended up staying in bed until like, until I'm sad to say I stayed in bed until about noon. But it's a long weekend here in Alberta, so nothing was really open anyways, but after that I did get out of bed, took some rollbacks, had a bath, took care of myself, did my morning workouts, alright, just 15 minutes and I do curls, and then I go for a long walk, do some Pokemon Go still thing, applied online for the KSC up the road, and I managed to get sorted out. I've got two job interviews this week. One on Thursday, and another one should be on the phone tomorrow, but we'll see how it works out. One with a Party City for management, and the other one with a insurance sales company. So hopefully that works out. Other good positive things that happened, working on the car thing. Hopefully I can get the car thing sorted out. Hopefully I can get somebody to buy it and go from there. But I got some ads up and got a little bit of interest, so we'll see how things go. Yeah, just kind of a weird, rough day. Like, I've been feeling really tired and really down all day. I'm having trouble keeping myself going. But I mean, the important thing is to set up a routine, and that's what I'm trying to do for myself. Wake up every day, do the workout, do the walk, do, you know, whatever I have to do to get to work. Got a couple other things in the works. I networked with a web developer and an IT guy to sell both of their services at commission, freelance. So that works out for me. I just gotta find people who need websites and IT services now. So back to cold calling. But I can make some money doing that. That's good. Squeaky chair. I should talk to some of the people I applied for jobs with. And I really need a haircut, I think, because this is getting disturbingly long. I guess I'm gonna go talk to people. I should find some money to get a haircut first. Yeah. So I guess I'm making progress. It was a tough day. Like, I really found it hard to keep going today. It was definitely one of those days where I did not want to get out of bed. I even had to force myself back out of bed because I went and had to lie down because I really wasn't feeling too well to come back and do the vlog. But I think it's important to, because this is kind of like therapy without a therapist. I can just talk and the internet hears me, and the response has actually been incredibly supportive since the last video, and I'm just amazed at how it's turned out so far. But yeah, I wanted to take today and go through what I owe and to who, and kind of organize everything out. So first things first is rent. So for the rent, I'm currently over about $2,900, plus for this month, $1,650. I don't know how well that can be seen in the video here. If it's all very big, I wonder if I can make that larger. Format, font, bigger. Okay. Does that show up now? Okay, that's a bit better. So, total, we're looking at, all right, here's the bit that's tricky about that. That's a lot of money to be owing my landlord right now. But my damage deposit is 1900. I'm never going to see that again. No matter how good I take care of the place, no matter how much I clean it, I'm never going to see it again. So I can make a case for that with my landlord because he was supposed to give me back 300 of that, and I never saw that again. And he's not usually a landlord. It's tricky. The situation with my landlord is he's not a landlord. He's a developer. He bought this place to bulldoze it and put up a bunch of like condominiums and duplexes. But one of the places on this block won't sell, so it's kind of in limbo now. He doesn't want me to really move out because then, well, he doesn't want to look for another renter, and it costs him more money for this place to be empty than it does with me here behind on rent. But because of that, he does a lot of things that a landlord's not supposed to do, so I also get a bit of leeway, so give or take. But anyways, so you minus 1900 from that, that means if I can come up with 2650, I can get him to like an equilibrium where I don't have to worry about it anymore. My power is paid up. Cable/internet. Before you guys ask, I don't actually have cable, it's just cable internet. That's about 250. Gas. And my gas company about $800. What else do I owe? Of course there's to be able to drive again. I'm going to have to come up with $2,400. And that's before I get a car. Back a friend who helped me out of a business failure a couple years back, and that is $4,000. That's not a high priority. That needs to be done. Okay. Alright. And then, of course, $7,000 in outstanding credit card bills. This is the monster that I need to slay. These amounts. And it's really foreboding when you put it together like that. Because if we just do a quick calculation of it, $17,100 outstanding. Then I need to put together and pay off. So if I sell the car, this can probably be taken care of. As far as day to day, it's all right, monthly costs. $16.50 for rent. this place is about 200 a month. Gas in this place is about 100 a month, less in the summer, more in the winter. Food, I can probably get by on about 100 bucks a month. How do we do that? Chicken, rice, and vegetables every day. Not particularly exciting meals, but you know, we better say 200 just to give us leeway. Internet. Gotta have the internet. Cost me about 100 bucks a month. Yay, Canadian internet services. And my phone, which costs me another 60 bucks a month. So, if we calculated that all together, yeah, it was math in this vlog. Super exciting. 1150 plus 200 plus 100 plus 200 plus 100 plus 60 equals 1810. Most baseline job I get, I'm probably going to make about $2,000 a month, leaving me with 190 bucks to pay off this other shit. And if we go nine years to get that shit paid down. I'm gonna need to make more money. I do a little better. My highest amount, because the most I ever made was about $4,000 a month. If I'm doing that, then it's a little bit better. Click there. 17100 and 219 here equals 7.80 months. So that's the goal. If that makes any sense. The goal is to make $4,000 a month. Every month. Currently my earning is zero. So I need to find a way to reach that goal. Alright, so what can I do? I got shit I can sell on Kijiji. I have commission contracts with other companies to sell their services. I'll make extra money. Get my other job, whatever it's going to be, and go from there. Also, oh, I could do voice acting work. Everybody says I have a good voice. I've got this Blue Snowball mic. That's like the minimum you need for voice acting, right? And maybe I can get some paid jobs there. I can continue to do freelance work, I can do video editing, and if I sell that car, that's going to knock a big chunk of money off of that too. Yeah. So, this is it. Sorry about the math, I know it doesn't make for exciting YouTubery, but thanks for taking this journey with me, you guys. And that's day two. Hopefully I feel better tomorrow. We'll take some more rollbacks tonight before bed, and we'll tackle this one day at a time. Thanks for watching. Take care. See you next time.